Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for April the 7th of 2020, well, it is titled A Path North. So what do we see here? Well, this is an image taken of the sky and showing the star trails that occur if you leave the camera open for an extended period of time. Now, in the foreground, you can see a lighted path. This is the path taken by the photographer as they walked further towards the north than the light that they were carrying. And you can, in fact, see their shadows at various points along the path. And up in the sky, the path is heading then true north because the north celestial pole is directly above that. And you can see the north celestial pole here, not directly, but as it is the central portion of all of the circles that we see here. The north celestial pole is the projection of the Earth's north pole out into the sky and is a fixed point in the sky, meaning that it does not change its position. So you can look at it today, and you can look at it tomorrow, and you can look at it next week and next year, and it's always going to be in the same place. The difficulty is that there is no direct way to see it, to tell where the North Pole is. Here we can see it easily because we can see where all of the star trails are converging, so we can identify the location of the pole. What we often do in the Northern Hemisphere is use the star Polaris. And Polaris is here just a little bit away from the North Pole, less but a degree or so. And it is very close to the North Celestial Pole. It helps us to be able to identify it. So Polaris is known as the Pole Star because it happens to be very close to the North Celestial Pole. Now, in the Southern Hemisphere, the same thing would occur, except that there is no bright star near the North Celestial Pole, so you would not have any way of easily identifying the North Celestial Pole by using a single star. Now, the pole has been used for navigation since ancient times, and that is because while the pole does not change for any given observer, its location in the sky depends on where you are on the Earth. So the further north you go, the higher it will get in the sky. And you can imagine that if you got all the way to the North Pole, the North Celestial Pole, which is the projection of the pole, would then be straight overhead. So it would get higher and higher in the sky until you reach the Earth's North Pole. If you head south, it would get lower and lower in the sky until you got to the equator, in which case the pole would be on the horizon. Now, this allows you to identify your latitude by how high the North Celestial Pole is above the horizon, and that would give you your latitude. And that was very useful, and especially useful in the days prior to GPS, that you could identify, for instance, when sailing across the oceans with no other landmarks and needing a way to tell whether you're drifting north or south. So you can tell that you're heading east or west, but how far north or south are you drifting? And you could watch the pole star and measure how high it was above the horizon. If it was getting too high in the sky, then you knew you were heading further north. If it was getting lower and lower in the sky, then you knew you were heading further south. And you could make course adjustments to try to make sure you would end up at the latitude that you intended when you got across the ocean. So that was our picture of the day for April the 7th of 2020. It was titled A Path North. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be contrasting skies. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.